I'm George Pradel, and I'm running for mayor.
I kind of wanted to have an opportunity to sit down and talk with you because we found a clip at NCTV from 1995.
Okay.
And it's you talking about running for mayor for the first time.
Yeah. The reason that I want to run for mayor and I want to be your mayor is that I want you to have a friend in City Hall.
The thing that struck me was how much you sounded like the mayor I know today. You were the mayor, or you were the candidate that wanted to have somebody have a friend in office, is what you said. And I thought that was so touching. And I'm wondering what you think about that today.
Well, I think that everybody wants to be able to call and find out what's going on. And they really want to talk to somebody when they call City Hall and they actually want to talk to the mayor. But what I found out was when I ran for mayor, people wanted to talk to somebody that would listen to them, and maybe they couldn't even help them, but it was just a feeling that they were part of the community. And that's what I kind of based my running on, was the fact that people wanted to be recognized. They didn't want to just be a person at such and such a block in Naperville. They wanted to be heard. So I thought, man, that would be pretty cool just to listen. Because sometimes people answer their own questions when you talk to them. So that's what I did. I still think that people like that. And I think they're getting that right now. You know, when you call the City Hall, you can get a hold of the mayor, you can get a hold of any of the supervisors from any of the divisions, and they'll call you back.
Well, I think that's one of the secret success for Naperville, because we're a large town.
Yes.
But yet we have that small town feel, and our council and our mayor are out in the community. They're recognizable. And I travel all over the place, and people are like surprised by Naperville residents wanting to know and getting to know their council and their mayor, because it's so foreign to them.
Well, the council's involved, and they're recognizable as they are around the town. And that's a good feeling, because it kind of holds us together.
Do you think when you were running, when you first decided to run for mayor, and I know you were a little bit persuaded, do you think having been a police officer was helpful to you?
Oh, yes, because I actually knew the people, and I knew the people that had been here a long time, and I knew where they lived, and I knew their families. And, you know, it was different when I first got on the police force. You know, I could say to the kids, now, Johnny, you know, if you don't be good, I'm going to call your dad or whatever. And it was easy for us to kind of control the kids because we had that family part of it. But as we got bigger, we grew out of it. But I just think it hasn't really lost its flavor along the way, but it's great. I look back to when I first ran for mayor, and it was different because I was a cop, and I told everybody that had asked me to run for mayor, I said, I don't want to be the mayor. I said, I'm a cop, you know. And but I knew the addresses, I knew all the streets, and I could visualize what people were doing because, you know, I talked to them as a cop, and I knew that some of them wanted to move to another area. Some wanted to have their kids go into college, and for them to be near, and they were really interested in staying here in Naperville. And so I thought, oh, I hope we can get them together because we don't want to have the taxes go so high that runs them out of town.
Right. Well, you certainly have helped keep Naperville together for 20 years. Was winning the election back in 1995, did that surprise you?
Yes. I didn't even have an acceptance speech. You know, I worked hard. I, you know, walked over all of the city, but when I won, I thought, wow, what am I going to say? And I had to put a speech in together, which was just, thank you, I'll try as hard as I can to do a good job for you. But I was kind of scared in a way because it was quite a difference from being on the street and talking to the people in uniform when I was in uniform to now being in City Hall. And I thought, man, what do I know about being a mayor? I don't know anything, you know, but I did know some things about budget because I was on a police department. And I did know some things about how to run different departments. But I thought, you know, I know all the people, I'll just ask them and learn on my own. So, you know, I would call like Alan Poole with the electric. So I learned a lot by just humbling myself and saying, I don't know what's going on, help me. And they did.
Isn't that a little bit of your servant leadership?
I think so. They criticized me for not having a platform. And I thought that we should have teamwork from the very beginning. And I thought that, everybody's opinion is really important. And so rather than, I wanted everybody to have a part in it, rather than me telling them what I expected.
Welcome to Naperville!
You are known throughout town for that enthusiasm, that team building smile that we just got right now, and welcome to Naperville, everybody wants it. Where did that come from?
It came from my mother was very enthusiastic, and she could cheer others on, and she always felt so good for other people. And so I pushed it a little bit because I wanted people to hear me when I was out in the public.
Thanks for being here!
And so I would yell loud, and I got used to it. And people got used to it too, because as I would yell, they'd say, hey, there's Pradel! Mm-hmm. So I kind of enjoyed that. But the enthusiasm was my bringing up that my mom and dad never wanted me to criticize others or, you know, stand in the way of their success, and, you know, to understand where people were coming. So I learned to respect at a very early age, and that's what people like. I'm just not bragging, it's just I felt that I had a personality that people liked.
Oh, and I would definitely agree with that. And I think it crosses all generations. Like, I've watched you walk into a room with children that you don't know, and your face lights up, and then their faces light up, and they're just instantly loving that you're. And next thing I know, you're dancing around with them, and I just think that's just wonderful.
Well, that's what I appreciated most was the love of the kids. When I first became a cop, I went to the chief. I said, Chief, Do we tell the kids in school what we do? Do we tell them that we love them? Do we tell them we're responsible for their health and safety? And he said, no, we've only got so many police officers. There's no overtime, and it would be wonderful. So then that's when I started the officer-friendly program by going into schools with my own dog and pony show and, letting people know what we do. And because I said, as a boy or girl in high school, you need to know, and we're on the same team. So we want to work together. So the chief let me do that.
That's awesome. Well, you certainly, as I said, crossed multiple generations. And I think it's because some of the kids knew you as officer friendly, and then they went to high school, and they would be hanging at the barn, and they would see you, and you could give them a look, and they would shape up, and then they became adults and brought their own and had their own children and their own family. So it carried across. You ran for mayor 5 times.
Yes.
Why 5 times? What did you love about it that kept you going?
I just felt the urging from the people in town to go for another term. You know, I could have quit after the first one or the second one, but I think that they were kind of getting used to the mayor and the way that I became a calming effect with the council. You know, we had some times where we really needed to bring some reality to the council, and I felt I was that calming effect. And so even though they didn't, some of them didn't agree with me, they still had respect. And we made some great opportunities for change.
I think that calming effect was part of that police personality. I do, because I've sat in the chamber many a time during that, and I felt like that's where that calming effect is coming from, is because you have to work as a police officer, you've had to break up many of things.
Yes.
Yes. So. Yes. Now that you're out of office and Mayor Cherico appointed you Mayor Emeritus.
That is so heartwarming to still be a part of the group by being the Mayor Emeritus. And it also, I've been told, makes it easier for people to greet me and say, hey, Mayor, I can still call you Mayor. And I said, yeah, I'm the Mayor Emeritus. And Mayor Cherico has graciously told people, you know, both of us are mayors. And so I don't have any problem with you calling him Mayor, you know. And he's earned that throughout the years, 20 years that he was the mayor.
That's awesome. Well, and I think you're very helpful to Mayor Cherico, because it's a big job, as you well know, and that you give him a little relief by handling some of the events for him.
Well, it's really heartwarming for me.
That's awesome. So Mayor Cherico is finishing up his first year as mayor. Do you remember your first year as mayor?
Yes, I do, and I know that I was cautious for the whole year. I didn't want to do anything wrong, and I was hoping that people would like me. And it was a different way of life, because being a cop, you know, you had a regimented time where you knew what you were doing all the time. I mean, well, you know, you knew that you were on patrol or whatever you were doing. And there were certain rules and regulations that you had to follow. So it was kind of organized like the military. And then when you become the mayor, you have to make some different choices, and you have to kind of make decisions right away. And 'cause in the police force, you make the decision after you've talked to the people and whatever. So it gives you a little opportunity, but with the mayorship, you know, you had to make decisions more often right away, instantaneously.
Right, sitting out of the council, everybody's voting, right?
Yeah.
When you think about when you were mayor, one of the things that we're excited about for 2016 is that the Water Street project is finally up and open.
Yay.
That's been a long time coming. That started during one of your terms.
Yes, about 5 years ago.
Right.
And I had a big part in it. And, you know, at first there was a little doubt that we should have that big a project in Naperville. But for me, I like it. And I think it's going to be a lot of impact on our economy. And also it's going to bring us better, closer together in the center of the town. And we need a hotel, because we've got a great college, North Central, here. And we have people coming to visit their children. And they have to stay, and they'd like to stay in the downtown area. Also, we have weddings, and they'd like to be in the downtown area. They don't have to move their cars afterwards, after the ceremony, and they can stay right here. It's a wonderful opportunity for residents and for guests.
Well, I think they've done a great job of getting that hotel and its other structures to fit where they said they were going to. I mean, it looks like it's been here. It doesn't stand out. You mentioned weddings, and I'm going to tell you a little story that I remember about you and weddings. It was, it's actually two stories in one, because you were always at the last fling event, you know, on Labor Day. You were driving around, and we NCTV would often be out covering it for news, and so we'd always look for you. And I was looking for you for on one Labor Day, which happened to fall on your birthday, which was September 5th.
Mm-hmm.
And I found you down by the Riverwalk, and you were taking pictures with a family that was getting some wedding pictures done, and they had found out you were the mayor, and you were they wanted to take a picture with you, and you were very kind. And then you helped the limo driver get through all the truck traffic over here.
Oh, yes.
You see, because you had, you know, your official shirt on.
Sure.
So people were letting him, you were kind of stopping traffic and letting the poor limo driver, sure, giving him some help. And I thought, well, gee, what mayor stops in the middle of everything he's doing, A, takes a photo with the family, directs traffic, and then hops on his four-wheeler.
I was always kind of nosy, and I would go to the weddings over at the settlement, mm-hmm, and then I'd say, hey, I'm the mayor. You're lucky to have the mayor come to your wedding or whatever. And they'd say, oh, can we have a picture, or can you ride with us in a chariot that they had or whatever. I just wanted to make it friendly, mm-hmm, in Naperville. I wanted them to feel that the mayor and everybody just was excited about their wedding. And so I'd go down there to the dandelion fountain. They took lots of pictures.
They
right
still
around
do,
there.
Yes.
And, you know, I'd stand around and watch, and I guess I was kind of nosy is the word that I have, but I kind of wanted to get involved and let people know that I was the mayor, but not to brag about it. You know, I just wanted to them to know that.
To share in that experience.
Yes, that we're sharing in their experience. So it's been wonderful. And we are a site for weddings in Naperville.
Absolutely.
So.
Yeah, no, I think people enjoy when you share, and you share so easily. Another thing that you share is September 5th is your birthday, and you would often invite anybody in town who had a September 5th,
yes,
birthday. And my niece, who lived with me for a while, happened to be a September 5th birthday. And so she came her first year. She was here. I think she turned 21.
Wow.
And she came in, and took a picture with her, and that was really sweet. And she's like, and she's from Florida. She's like, what mayor does that? I'm like, well, ours does.
Yeah.
So it was great.
I always thought that September 5th was a good birthday because there were some very famous people on there. And but the most famous are the people of Naperville. And so Betty Worley was one that I first met, that we said, you know, we should form a club, you know, and have all of us have a little party on the 5th of September. So we did, and it got bigger and bigger, and we used to write to Bob Newhart and Willie Gault, who was on the Bears, and we would invite everybody, and so, you know, it was special for us, because September 5th was important to those that had their birthday that day. We were even in the parade a couple times. We had a wagon that we were on, you know, a hay wagon, and we'd have a big sign about the 5th. And so it just brought us together. It was just another way of saying to a certain group, hey, let's get together to enjoy each other on the September 5th. And as we sat around the table, we'd say, now, when were you born? Oh, you're a morning baby, you know. And you were born on Labor Day. Oh, that's wonderful. So it just, people had a time where they could really enjoy their birthday and tell about themselves.
I think that's wonderful. And, you know, as a community, I'm always amazed at how, for being a large community, how much we come together when somebody needs us, whether it be a birthday celebration or there's a fundraiser for a family in need, or when we found out that you were ill and, you know, a little mailbox was set up by Katie Wood downtown.
Oh, that was so touching. You know, when I saw it out there when I drove by, and it was really nice to see that mailbox for Mayor Emeritus Pradel, but it also warmed my heart because people wrote lots of things that they wouldn't write in a regular card. Mm-hmm. So they'd write to me and say, you know, we're praying for you, and we're just you're in our thoughts. And, you know, here's the, when I first met you, this is what was my impression. And it just kind of warmed my heart. I saved them, and I'm reading them, and find out, you know, that people really wanted to express themselves more than what's in a regular card that they buy.
I think sometimes when people get an opportunity to write a letter, like that. They're taking it more and more because it's a very personal thing, as opposed to an email or a text or something like that. And how is your health today? How are you doing
right
now?
My health is a lot better, thanks to all the people who have kept me in their prayers and also in their thoughts. And I receive a couple letters every day hoping that I'll get better. And so, you know, when I was in the hospital, people came to see me, and I was very touched by that. When I was in Tabor Hills in the nursing home, people came to see me and tell me what was going on, and I appreciate that too. So I felt in my sickness, I just wanted to get to a point where I could walk again. And now I've gone through the process of being in a wheelchair to a walker, and then a four-legged cane, and now a single cane. And I'm taking therapy through DuPage Medical, and I'm in Lyle, and they're really working the daylights out of me. And so I went to church one day and I said, wow, I'm excited because I get to wear shoes today. Look, I'm wearing shoes. And people are like, you know, what's going on? But my feet were so swelled that I couldn't wear shoes. And then through all the exercises and things that I've had, and then they cut back my medicine, so it made it easier for things to coordinate there in my body. So
doing better, sounds
like.
Yeah, you look great.
Well, thank you.
So I bet that physical therapy reminds you a little bit of that Marine training.
Yes, it does.
That's right.
They give you a challenge, and I like challenges. So, and I still hear people saying, though, you know who that person is? He used to be the mayor of Naperville, you know. Oh, come on, I'm just trying to get better.
That's great. You inspire so many people. Who inspires you?
I think starting out with my mother's family. My dad came from Germany, so I never really knew his family. He didn't have, a mom and dad, but he didn't have any brothers or sisters. But my mother came from a very inspiring family. And so I think that they inspired me because they always had the best to say about others. And they always had a good time. You know, every Sunday we used to go to my grandma's house in Chicago, and all the relatives would be there until soon it got way over. Her house just became so small, and it didn't change, but there were just so many people. So, but everybody was really inspired. And my faith and religious training had a lot to do with that too. So I think that God was good, still is, and he gave me the inspiration to inspire others, you know. I never wanted to hurt anybody or run people down. So I felt that, you know, make them your friend by praising them, you know. It's easier to criticize sometimes than it is to praise people. You got to find something good about them, and so you have to search a little bit. You know, you can find things to criticize people about real easy, but sometimes it's a little harder to say, oh, I didn't know that you did this or you did that. Wow, thank you for doing that. And nowadays I get acquainted with the veterans, and I'll say, thanks for serving. I'll see somebody that's got a hat on that says some ship that they were on or whatever. Hey, thanks for your service. And they really take that to heart, and they feel like, you know, we really appreciate them, and we do.
Do you think that attitude that you got from your mom and your dad, that inspiration, helped you be a better cop? Because most cops don't go in trying to to find the better of somebody breaking in.
I was called officer friendly, and I was called kitty cop, and you know, I had a different philosophy than others, you know. When I stopped people, you know, well, it was such a small town when I first got on, and I said that I would notify their parents, and that seemed to be a good philosophy to follow. But I gave a lot of breaks to people, and I'd say, you know, if I catch you again, you know, I'm going to write you a ticket, you know. And so I gave a lot of people breaks, and the other officers would say, why are you such an easy guy out there, you know. And I said, well, that's just my nature, you know. So maybe I should have arrested more people than I did, but I think I got good results out of it. You know, I still hear from some of the young people, and they'll say, you gave me my first ticket. I did. Well, look how you turned out. You're so great, you know. And they love to hear that, and they brag about the fact that I gave them their first ticket. And I don't know if I think a lot of people want to talk that they got a ticket at all. But, you know, now I think that people kind of want to tell others that, wow, the mayor gave me a ticket. And I said, I wasn't the mayor, I was a cop, you know.
Right. I think, you know, today police enforcement is so much about prevention and really stepping in to help. I think maybe you were just a little bit ahead of your time back then.
Yes. Well, I was all for the community at that time. Community policing, I was way ahead of my time. And even the other officers that are now chiefs of police around here, that's what the comment they made when we all got together, that community policing was my bag. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it became a big program in the police world, but I had already talked about that. I was trying to build trust in the police department, you know, and I did it through the children, and you know, it's the parents. Maybe they didn't agree with me, but if you win over the children, then they can't tell their kids, oh, he's too harsh a cop or whatever, you know. So it was a good experience.
Well, I think the image that comes to mind when you said you it was about the children was you leading them with their big wheels in the Labor Day parade. I think everybody looked forward to that.
I just talked to the lady that took a very famous picture of the kids in the big wheels, and I she said, "Do you remember me?" And I said, "Yes." She took that special picture, and she told me that it's around town in several locations. Mm-hmm. And even some of the media would say, you told us that if we stood in front of the children in Safety Town, stand aside, because if you give the order, they're going to run me over. And I said, well, that could be, because at that age, they think everything you say is the truth, and they respect you, and they want to do everything you say. So if you say, go, you know, and then they go. So that picture is very famous, but those kids just ate that up to the big wheels.
Oh, they did.
And we always had, in fact, I still, in the parade, I stay with my group of Safety Town kids, and we just have such a good time.
Well, Safety Town is another great institution that you helped found through that officer-friendly idea of community policing, ahead of your time again, ahead of your time.
And they gained respect for police officers in the Safety Town. They also gained respect for themselves, because we talked about water safety, we talked about bus safety, school bus safety, we talked about railroad safety, we talked about all the good things, but we also made it a reality, because we'd take them to the train station and show them those big trains going by, let them feel that breeze as they went by the station when they were all lined up against the wall, and we had our leaders protecting them. But it's exciting when you hear that big train coming, and it's coming close to you, and you know, the guy blows the whistle or whatever. And then when you go to the beach and somebody falls in and they save them and pull them out. It's planned, but it's reality. The kids just watch, you know. And then when the fire engines come and they, you know, blow their sirens and they take the hose and then they let the kids shoot the hose. And the pressure's pretty tough in those fire engines. Mm-hmm. So they'll kind of push them back. And then when the cops come, then they let them, somebody be handcuffed and whatever, that show them that, you know, it's good to be good and stay away from the bad side of the police officers.
With all those things that maybe as parents, you know, they get very busy, they don't have time to think about all the safety training that everybody needs. So it's a wonderful institution.
Well, I will tell you that I probably would be really criticized and probably be in jail if I did all the things that I did with going into the schools, because I used to take a weapon to the school lectures, and I'd say, I don't ever want you to play with a gun, and I'd hold a gun up in the air, and I'd say, because you never know, bang, and it went off, and I had blanks in there, and the kids would be looking up at the ceiling to see where the hole was. And if I did that now, I would be in jail, because that would be considered wrong.
Might be a little over the top.
But you know, the kids still tell me, oh, I remember when you came to the school and you shot your gun and we were looking for the hole in the ceiling. So a lot of things change in this world, but I don't regret that I ever did some of those things with hands-on policy.
Hands-on policy. Well, I love that. Tell me something that we might not know about you. We've talked about a lot of things I think people love about you. Is there something we don't know about you?
When I was a cop, I also at night was a dog catcher in town. And the other thing was, I also got appointed by the mayor to be weed commissioner. And so I have a certificate that says weed commissioner of Lyle and Naperville Township.
Is this weed as in cannabis, or is this weed
as far as cannabis. It was weed control, you know, where people let their yards and whatever grow, and we had some restrictions that you couldn't have, you know, a lot of weeds and a lot of grass, real tall grass. And so I used to write a couple tickets every week. And
that's hilarious.
Yeah.
You are Naperville's, without a doubt, Naperville's number one cheerleader. What makes Naperville so great in your mind?
The people of Naperville are so great. You know, we have a lot of people that watch out for each other, and they have neighborhood watch. And if something is wrong at the neighbor's house or there's something suspicious, they'll call. And I think that's why our crime rate is really low, is because people care about each other. You know, they don't just walk away. And, you know, and a late experience for me is I realize that people are watching and taking note of what's going on, because I have a cart. It's, you know, that it's a motorized cart. And I was sitting in front of my house, and it was around 4 o'clock in the afternoon. And so I kind of held my head down and kind of leaned on the handlebars. And somebody went by and they called the fire department and the police. And so I heard the sirens, and I was just sitting out there, and all of a sudden the police officer came up to the corner. And then he waved the fire engine to right in front of my house. So they stopped, and I thought they were just visiting. So I said, hey, why are you here? And they said, because of you. Somebody called and said that they thought you had passed out on your little scooter. And I said, oh, thank you. But that's Naperville, you know. And so I just appreciate them calling because they were concerned. It was really a surprise, because I said, where are you guys going? You know, because they stopped in front of the house. They said, "We're here to see about you."
That's hilarious.
Yeah, it is.
And let's talk a little bit about your family. You have you had your lovely wife Pat, who
yes.
lost recently.
Yes.
And then you've got two boys and a girl.
Yes.
And tell me a little bit about what makes them special.
Well, because they care about their daddy right now because he's sick. But they're special because they take an interest in Naperville too. You know, where were you born? And actually, two of my children were born right here at Edward. And my firstborn was born in Chicago. But I think that they have a sense of being part of Naperville, not just as, you know, I don't hear them saying, you know, "Oh, I'm the mayor's child," unless people ask them when they go to cash a check or they have their name. I think, and each one is independent, you know, and they want to do the best for Naperville. And so I'm thrilled that the family cares about Naperville and they care about each other and they care about family life. So I'm very thrilled about that.
Well, I think oftentimes that we have been lucky that we have not only you, but we've had your entire family, and
well,
that's such a gift.
The only thing I kind of regret is that in my five terms, that in my last term, I didn't take more time to understand the feelings of my wife. She was totally for Naperville. You know, we've got lots of articles where she had said good things about Naperville and gave me the opportunity to do it. You know, if I wanted to go somewhere, she'd let me go, and she was a big part of it. And then they renamed Safety Town after her now, so it's the George Pat Pradel Safety Town. And that's a tribute to me. They've also done some other things for her. And you know, it means a lot to me to have family. Family life is really, really important. And so I just thank God for the opportunity to serve.
Well, thank you for taking time to talk to us today and to me.
Wonderful.
I loved it. It's nice to catch up with you. And thank you for all you do and everything
well,
you continue to do.
Thank you. And I just hope that Naperville continues to be the friendly town and the safest town for its size in the United States, and that people stick together and all the different ethnic groups that we have, that they understand that we care and love them and want to make sure that they become a part of Naperville. That's why we've got some different groups, like the Chinese group, is we've got a leadership in that. The Asian group, the Chinese, and they work together. And then we have a lot of other groups that are represented. And it's just great to see different ethnic groups getting together. And, you know, we also have a big Indian group in Naperville. And so they had a parade this year that was second to none. And they had brought somebody from India that was a movie star, singer. And this place was just jammed. And so it's so nice because we're becoming metropolitan. And but when you ask them, "Where are you from?" "Naperville." And we're very proud of it. So let's keep it up.
Excellent.
And let's keep up the fact that Naperville is proud of every citizen that we have here, and we want to take care of each one in the city. So, Council, thank you for what you're doing, and we're behind you 100%.